Hey guys, so we're going to be talking about periods today. Don't worry, I'm going to make this easy for you. I'm Miss Haridas, and this is the Study Hive. Today's lesson is all about the menstrual cycle. Now, many students find this topic really hard, so I'm going to really simplify it for you. So you should be quite confident by the end of this lesson, hopefully. Now, the three main objectives of this lesson is one, to understand the different parts of the female reproductive system, so the anatomy of it. Two is to know there are four main hormones involved in the menstrual cycle and how do they affect the menstrual cycle. And three is how do contraceptives work. So key words just to focus on are words such as ovaries, the pituitary gland, which is a gland that's found in the brain. So remember, glands secrete hormones and they travel through the blood. The hormones involved are LH, which is luteinizing hormone, FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, estrogen, progesterone, ovulation, which is when the egg gets released, and what does an embryo mean? We'll talk about that in today's lesson. So the anatomy of the female reproductive system, we really need to understand the different parts in order to be able to see how they affect the menstrual cycle. So if I start off with the on the left-hand side, you've got your ovary. Now you have two ovaries, both one on this side, and you can see one on this side. So two ovaries, and in that ovary, you will usually find the egg. So it's very different things. The second thing I'm gonna talk about here is the oviduct. That is also otherwise known as the fallopian tube. So the oviduct and the fallopian tube are the same thing, and you can see it just connects the ovary from here all the way. So it starts from here, the oviduct, and it connects it all the way there, and you've got two there. Just underneath that, you've got these ligaments. Now these ligaments keep the ovary in place. And then underneath that, you have the uterus, which is the wall, a muscular wall, and it's really important because that's where the embryo or the zygote will get implanted into that wall if a pregnancy was to occur. On the left-hand side, you've got the cervix, and the cervix is a ring of muscles, and it's just at the lower end of the uterus, and it connects the uterus to the vagina, which is the opening of the female reproductive system. So you can pause this video if you want, and just in your head, go through the different parts, just so that you feel confident with the anatomy of the female reproductive system. So if I move forward, again, this is an activity, if you have time, it wouldn't take more than 10 minutes just to have a go at, or you can skip and move forward. But what you will require is a pipe cleaner or a piece of string, and you will also need some coloured beads, so three different coloured beads, or you could use pasta, coloured pasta, or anything that is helpful to make a bracelet or a necklace. So pause this video, go get your equipment, and come back and we'll make this together. So if I explain the first part of the bracelet. So tie your string up and we look at the first five. So choose one colour and put the first five beads in. So what you should see is the first five beads in one colour. So mine's are green. Then the second part, if you take a different colour and you need eight beads of this colour, so my beads here are yellow, and then you want to put that through in the string. Then you want to choose one real distinct colour, so something that's different. So I've chosen red, you can choose blue if you want, and then again, string in another 14 beads and then tie it up around your wrist or around your neck, and what you have effectively made is your first period bracelet. So congratulations! Sounds really gross, but there is a method to the madness. So if I talk about the menstrual cycle, so this bracelet represents your cycle. So the females undergo this menstrual cycle, and the first 5 days so my beads in green here, so these first 5 days here represents your period, when a female has her period. So it's usually bleeding that takes place over 4 to 5 days. The uterus lining, that muscular wall, is really being shedded. The egg is being released out of the female because pregnancy did not take place. So a woman has her period once every 28 days, or once a month roughly, and it usually lasts about 5 days. The next 8 days after that, if you look here, the lining of the uterus needs to start building up. So I'm going to just put building up uterus lining. So you really want to build that uterus lining up in preparation for pregnancy if it was to occur. And that one distinct color over here, this color, this red bead that I have, represents day 14. And day 14 is the key day when ovulation takes place. So that's when the egg is released. And then the next 14 days after that really is just the maintenance. So we're going to maintain the uterus lining because we're waiting to see if the egg is going to be fertilized by some sperm and so that it can be implanted into the uterus. So we want to really maintain that uterus lining. And if it doesn't, which is usually the case, we start off in day one again, which starts here, and we'll reset the whole cycle, and then the female will undergo her period again, and the cycle continues. So that is a representation of the menstrual cycle. What are the four hormones involved in the menstrual cycle? So the main ones that we will look at is FSH, LH, estrogen, and progesterone. Now, FSH stands for follicle stimulating, hormone. And LH stands for luteinizing hormone. So FSH, LH, estrogen, and progesterone are the four hormones involved in the menstrual cycle. Where are they made? So there's two parts of this menstrual cycle that are really a key. So the first one I've drawn for you over here is the pituitary gland, and the pituitary gland is generally found in the brain, and it's a gland that secretes, which means releases, the hormone LH, and it also secretes the hormone FSH. And in the same way, the hormones that are released from the ovaries are progesterone and estrogen. So four hormones, a really easy way to remember this is I will always remember that the abbreviated words, the short ones, LH and FSH, are always coming from the pituitary gland, whereas the longer words like progesterone and estrogen are released from the ovaries. So now that we know where they're released, we want to know how they actually work. So what happens first is the hormone that's released from the pituitary gland is FSH. And what FSH does is there's a little egg that's starting to develop in the ovaries, so I'm just starting to draw, and FSH causes that egg to mature. So you can see I'm just making it a little bigger to show that it's maturing. Whilst this is happening, FSH also causes the release of the next hormone, which is estrogen. So FSH causes the release of estrogen. What does estrogen do? So estrogen, I'm going to change the colour here, says, okay, well, the egg is clearly matured. We don't need it to mature anymore. So FSH, your job is done. You don't need to be released anymore. So estrogen stops the release of FSH and instead causes another hormone to be released, which is LH. And what does LH do? LH says, okay, the egg is mature, but we can't leave it in the ovary. It needs to be released. It needs to be released and it needs to go into the oviduct. So now the egg is released from the ovary into the oviduct. And this key point here on day 14 is called ovulation. So luteinizing hormone, LH, is responsible for ovulation. And the final hormone that we can talk about is the hormone progesterone. And again, it's released from the ovaries. So here's progesterone. And the key thing about progesterone is it really maintains the lining of the uterus over here. So progesterone maintains that lining and it's released from the ovaries. So let's simplify this even more. So we know that there are four hormones involved in the menstrual cycle. There's FSH, there's LH, there's estrogen, and there's progesterone. Let's just move that whole thing slightly here so you can see it. Now, where are they actually released from? So we know that the first two FSH and LH are released from the pituitary gland, which is found in the brain. And progesterone and estrogen are released from the ovaries. So that's the second question we know where they're released from. The third thing is, what do they actually do? What are they responsible for? So FSH is responsible for two things. One, it causes the egg to mature. And FSH also causes estrogen to be released. So that's FSH. What does LH do? Well, LH is responsible for ovulation, and that is when the egg is released on day 14. Estrogen, what is it responsible for? So that's two things that it does. So estrogen stops the release of FSH and causes the release of LH. And finally, the last hormone, which is progesterone, and progesterone is involved in maintaining, so it maintains the lining of the uterus. So that's four hormones, where they come from and what they do. Let's simplify this even further to show you a little feedback mechanism of how it works. So the first thing is, you've got FSH over here, and we know that it's involved with egg maturing, causes the egg to mature. So what does it actually cause? It causes estrogen to be released. So we'll put a little tick there, because it causes estrogen to be released. But what does it stop? It stops, it's a little bit across there, it stops FSH from being released. And then when estrogen is released, what does it cause? So it causes LH to be released. So let's put a good little tick there. And what does LH do? Well, that actually causes ovulation on day 14. So that's a really simplified way to see the diagram. So then we can look at, how does fertility drugs or contraceptives work in this mechanism? So to really give context to this topic, fertility drugs, so to decrease fertility, so if I put a little, let's choose, what colour shall we go for? Let's go for green. If I want to decrease fertility, so I put an arrow going downwards, I would put the hormone estrogen into my pill. So the contraceptive pill actually has estrogen in there. And can you just take a moment, so you can pause this if you want, to have a think about why a contraceptive pill might have estrogen. So if you look at estrogen, what does estrogen do? Well, estrogen stops FSH. And if it stops FSH, it's going to stop that egg from maturing. So it's going to make it difficult for you to get pregnant, because the egg isn't mature enough to be released. But on the opposite side, if I wanted to increase fertility, so I put a positive arrow going upwards, then I'm going to add two hormones. I'm going to add FSH and LH. So FSH and LH. And what does that do? So have again a little think. What does FSH and LH do? So FSH here, it causes estrogen to be released, and when estrogen is released, it's going to cause LH luteinizing. And what does that result in? It's resulting in the egg to be released. So you can have the egg to be released, that's going to increase your chances of getting pregnant, and that's how fertility drugs work. So I hope that makes it simplified and you really understand the topic on the menstrual cycle. Just to summarise what you've learnt in today's lesson, so you can name the different parts of the female reproductive system. You understand that the menstrual cycle is on average 28 days, with day 14 representing ovulation, which is the release of the egg. There are four main hormones involved in the menstrual cycle, which is LH, FSH, estrogen and progesterone. LH and FSH are released from the pituitary gland, and estrogen and progesterone are released from the female ovaries. The FSH is responsible for the egg to actually mature, whereas LH is responsible for the egg to release into the oviduct. estrogen stops the release of FSH and causes the release of LH, and progesterone is the hormone involved with actually maintaining the lining of the uterus. Really important when women are pregnant that there's always a high amount of progesterone so that lining is always maintained. And then fertility drugs, if we use contraceptive pills, it usually has some estrogen in it. And if we're trying to increase fertility, then we would put the hormone FSH and LH. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Thank you for watching. Leave a comment below if you have any questions and I'll get back to you. Subscribe to our channel if you want more videos. We're also on Instagram, thestudy.hive, if you want up-to-date information and my quirky science videos. Bye. 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 That's a bit more serious. Bye.